You are never dependent on the wind. You can't find those in me. You leave the simple wings like eagle.
I'm devil has no longer any hold on our life. And in case he forgot, just remind him that you belong to Jesus. And he has no hold over you. And you are no longer a slave to fear. You are no longer a slave to guilt. You are no longer a slave to sin. Because God has bought you with a price. And it doesn't matter what the devil might want to tell you every single day of your life. Remind yourself that you are a child of God. You are a child of God. Remind yourself you are a child of God.
For you are the God of all nations, and for your name we do not fear, Father. We thank you, we give you all the glory, Father. We pray for peace, we pray for your peace, Father. For all the nations that have elections this year, we pray for peace, Father. We pray that your Lord will choose leaders, Father, leaders to glorify your name, Lord. Father, we pray for Russia, we pray for US, we pray for Ghana, Lord. Father, we pray that you, O Lord, will choose people to lead your nations, Lord. We give you glory, for Father, you have done it for us. We have no fear. We have no fear because you are our Lord. We thank you, Father. We give you glory. We worship your holy name. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lord, able to stand still. What kingdom can stand still, Lord Jesus? Because you can move the mountains and nothing is impossible for you. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for the wonderful spirit that you give us today. The spirit of worship. The spirit of trust. The spirit of love. All those gifts that you give us for God. And we give all the praise and glory to you, Jesus. In your precious name. Amen. With all your resources. I want you to trust me with your tithing and your offering. And you know what? He won't ask for one tenth. He wants for one tenth to go towards his work, towards the church, towards his bride. And you know what is going to happen if you pay your tithing? It'll be wonderful because the work will go on. Do you know what is going to happen if you don't pay your tithing? The work of God will go on. Amen to this.
Amen.
Because our God is faithful. Our God is faithful and he is slow to anger. And he abounds in faithfulness. That's what the Psalm, the book of Psalms is saying. And you know, he trusted us just a little bit with the money. And he says, whoever is trustworthy in what is least is also trustworthy in what is in great things. He wants us to trust him with little things so that he would give us more. And today, let us just give to our God freely. We have a poem today, I believe, by Brother Dan Walker. Yes. Bless us.
Good morning, church. Please lend me 5 minutes of your time. Please pay attention. This was written from deep down in my heart. So something that I didn't just write it because I could write, but I wrote it because knowing the way of giving me, and I believe it would minister to you, so please listen and okay? To say God never fails, and that always his grace prevails. But seriously, how true can that be? Because looking at my life right now, I see no sign of his victory. It seems I've failed miserably. Everything seems to be falling apart. There's this ache in my heart. I feel pain, all is dark. So where is his light? For nothing seems to be right. Where is his light? For nothing seems to be right. And yet they say that God never fails, and that his people he will not forsake. But all night and day we pray and seek his face. But still we lack the manifestation of these answers. Perhaps this God is just absent. We call, but he remains silent. Who then must we trust? For it seems this God has failed us. Who then must we trust? For it seems this God has failed us. But wait! Hold on. Just wait. God never fails. God never fails. So then, what is the true meaning of failure? And who is this God we speak of? To fail is to fall short. To be deficient and insufficient, unable to attain success in something expected and attempted. But by what standard do you measure failure? By your own worldview? or by what people expect of you. What defines failure for you? It's that simple. How do you define failure? Now think of this. When we say God, we talk about a transcendent being, the Almighty Elohim, one who is all-knowing. He is exalted in glory and forever remains holy. He is perfect, always has been. In him is no shortcomings. So, where is room for failure for one who can make anything possible? Now that seems illogical and impossible. There is no room for failure for one who can make anything possible. Now that's who God is. He and failure cannot coexist. So you are not a failure if you are with God. But if you think you are, then you have got the definition wrong. You are not a failure if you are with God. But if you think you are, then you have got the definition wrong. Like they say, God never fails. But there are times I felt he failed me. But the Almighty can prove himself worthy of my utmost praises. So if the question is, what are the chances of God ever failing? Then the answer is, what are the chances of the dead ever praying? To think that God can ever fail or has ever failed is to think that man can never fail and will never fail. But I understand that time and time again, you pray and seek his face, but nothing seems to change. You still feel the pain and the suffering still remains. But know this for sure, that our situation is anything but the result of God's failure. No, that's not his nature. Yeah, let God be true and every man a liar. So why choose to believe what the preacher says, that God never fails? Not because they said it, but because Yahweh himself has promised that he will never fail. And faithful is he who promised. For I know who I have believed, and I'm persuaded that he is able to keep that which I committed unto him against that day. So together in faith, let's all say, God never fails. Come on, say it with me.
Good morning, George. All the youth group in the house. All the youth in the house is dismissed now. To welcome our first time guests, our visitors in ICA would like you to stand and tell us what country you are from. First time guest in the house. Can you give them an ICA welcome applause? And we would like to acknowledge from a very young lady in front. Where are you from, Mom? From Nigeria. Welcome to ICA. And how about you, sir? Where are you from? Nigeria. And you are from that country. Welcome to ICA. And how about you, sir? Where are you from?
Ghana.
From Ghana! And how about you, miss? Where are you from?
From Philippines.
Salamat po at kapanya ito. As the psalmist says, I will rejoice as he said to me, let us go unto the house of the Lord. I know that I say we're rejoicing that you were here. Amen. And as our ushers give you the first time visitors card, kindly fill it up with the needed info. And after the service, you can exchange it with a very exclusive gift only from ICA. Just turn to your left and you can see the Welcome Guest Center. Thank you and enjoy the fellowship.
I guess my mic was off. Good morning, how you doing? Well, good to be back. Good to see you. Oh, thank you. You guys are awesome. Welcome to those who returned in the last couple of weeks. We missed you guys. And we are jealous of you because you guys had a great time at your home country, eating all that nice home-cooked food. Anyways, I'm going to just briefly update you on what's going on at the church in the next couple of weeks and today. So as you guys already know, so today is a regular Sunday. It means we're having three services. So obviously this, you are in the English service right now. We start at 10:30 every Sunday. Following the English service at 12:30, we're having the Russian service. And following the Russian service, there's a Filipino service at 2:30. All right, thank you. Okay, also following the English service, we got two other things going on. Number one is we are having a Filipino discipleship class. So you guys feel free to join if you haven't done it yet. And we also have an English Bible study, which we call Bread and Butter, but it's just a code name. Don't be misled. Don't get it wrong. Don't get it twisted. We are studying the book of 1 Timothy right now. We just basically go chapter by chapter, verse by verse. Feel free to join us. Looking forward to seeing you there. If you're a teenager, I'm sure you guys already heard Maya announce it before. We are having a youth group today, and you are dismissed, and everyone is meeting in room number one. Before I continue, let me make a quick commercial break and call Tariro on stage. Is that correct, Tariro, Andy? Just put your hands together for Sunday School Department. They have a very special announcement to make. And this is one of the most important ministries in the church. Thank you. Okay, paper in here. We basically are looking for those who would like to be baptized.